Hello all, I'm Sai and you're watching The Book Dragon. In today's video, I'm bringing to you 10 books with actually relevant book titles. So without any further ado, let's get into the video because this is going to be a very short and crisp video and not a chatty one. The first two books are from the same series and they are from the DC Icon series, hence I'm wearing my Batman t-shirt. So the first book is Batman Nightwalker by Murray Liu. Now in this book, we deal with Batman, who's Bruce Wayne, as a teenager, that is a 17-year-old guy. A young adult, normally for a young adult novel, and the plot actually is between Batman and a nightwalker named Madeline, and she's trying to manipulate Batman. Will he figure it out and help the others, or will he get manipulated? That's the actual story of Batman Nightwalker. The next book is Wonder Woman Warbringer by Leigh Bardugo. Now in this book we have Wonder Woman also as a 17-year-old girl, as Diana, as we all know, and she has to find a way in order to lift the curse of this other girl called Alia, who's from a very normal place in New York, and she's so rich. Okay, that's one of the reasons why she's targeted a lot. She's also a warbringer, hence this title Wonder Woman Warbringer, because the story actually revolves around Wonder Woman and Warbringer alone. But if you ask me, more than the Wonder Woman, it focuses more on the Warbringer, and that's the interesting part of the story. The next book in the list is Strange the Dreamer by Lainey Taylor. Now this book's title is actually so little because this book deals with the story of a young man named Laszlo Strange. He's a librarian, but apart from just being a librarian, he's also a big, big dreamer. That is, he dreams about this city named Weep. Actually, the name of the city is not Weep. It is this place in this world where magic thrives a lot, and it is the city of the gods. It is ruled by the gods, most probably. And what happens is, nearly 20 years ago, the gods were befallen and the city was taken over by the human beings. Hence, a curse has fallen on all the human beings around the world, and the curse is that anyone who tries to utter the name of the city, they forget the name and it is replaced automatically by the word Weep. And even when they think about it, the actual name of the city is not uttered and it is always replaced by this word Weep. And Laszlo just keeps on dreaming about the city Weep because it's his fantasy and it's his dream, and finally he gets to live his dream. Whether the dream is good or not is up to you when you're reading it. The next one is Elantris by Brandon Sanderson. Now in this book we have the city named Elantris, and in order to live in Elantris, a person needs to become an Elantrian. In order to become an Elantrian, a person needs to be attacked by a disease called the Shayod, and once a person gets attacked by the Shayod, they get these natural superpowers, and hence they are considered like godlike beings, and with that power they keep on helping the people. But what happens is, before 10 years from the book starts, some curse falls and anyone who gets the Shayod becomes an Elantrian, but it's not considered as a gift anymore. It's just treated as a curse, and the people are just thrown into Elantris and they are left to survive there as long as they can. They are not fed or cared about in any way. Essentially, they are just zombies living in a city called Elantris. But what happens in the story that you have to know is, what would happen when a crown prince to a kingdom is attacked by the Shayod and becomes an Elantrian, and how the kingdom prevailed then. This ties in magic, religion and fates, as well as very cool, funny characters in a really good way. And if you're expecting something so lighthearted yet very, very fun to read, then you have to read Elantris by Brandon Sanderson. The next one is Eragon by Christopher Paolini. Now this is the first book in the Inheritance Cycle Quartet by Christopher Paolini. Just on seeing the cover itself, many people might misunderstand that the name of the dragon on the cover is Eragon, but it's not. The name of the dragon is Saphira, and it's a she dragon, so the dragon is a female, and the dragon rider's name is Eragon, and he's a he. And the relationship between Eragon and Saphira is just so beautiful. They are just able to feel each other in a really good way. Okay, they are just connected by the souls, and it's really, really good to read. If you're a person who likes nostalgic stuff, then you will have to read Eragon because it's really good. Also, Eragon is supposed to be the first dragon rider in centuries, and there's a reason behind why he was chosen as the first dragon rider. And will he fulfill his destiny or not? In order to know that, you'll have to read Eragon by Christopher Paolini. Next one is The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak. This book is about a little girl named Liesel, and the story actually takes place in Nazi Germany during World War II, and it's just really good in every sense. I cannot tell that the book has a huge plot or anything, but the characters in this book are the ones which drive the story in a really good way. It's not at all fast in any sense, okay? Don't mistake this book to be a fast-paced story and get into it. It's really, really slow. It's really, really big. So if you're a slow reader and likes reading slow-paced books, then this is like a treat for you. Just go ahead and read it because it will make you feel sad and happy, and it will just throw you into this whirlpool of emotions. Another special thing about this book is that it is narrated from the point of view of death, so it's even more beautiful that too during the time of World War II. The relevance with the title of the book is that Liesel, the main character of the story, is actually a book thief, hence it has the title The Book Thief. And I'm sure that if you read it during this time of the year, October, November, then you'll be enjoying this book a lot more. Next one is The Belated Bachelor Party by Ravinder Singh. This book is about four men who used to be friends and roommates during college, and nearly a decade after they have finished college, they are married and settled now. They plan to take a tour together to Europe, and there are many things which happened during this tour. And all the four of them, they have not had bachelor parties before their marriages, along with the other three people. Hence, they plan to come together and celebrate their friendship for a short while and then part ways again. But while they try to celebrate, there are many things which happen, and I'm sure that everyone will be able to relate with this book at least to a short extent. And don't mistake this book to be a story just for boys because it's about four men. I'm sure that anyone can read it and enjoy it equally, because it just draws moments from friendships that can be related by anyone who has friends. And I'm sure that if you read this, you'll just feel light, calm and very happy. Next one is The Girl on the Train by Paula Hawkins. This is a psychological thriller about a woman named Rachel who takes this train every day to work. And Rachel has this habit of looking out the train and just seeing the houses that the train's passing by. But she has this specific house which she notices a lot more compared to the other houses, mainly because the train goes a bit slower there, and there's a young couple who are residing in that home. What happens one day is Rachel witnesses something which she thinks is not normal, and after that there's this murder mystery which unveils itself. But Rachel's not sure if what she saw is actually what she thinks, and vice versa, and she has very various dilemmas. It's a psychological thriller, so I'm sure that it's very much suitable for this monsoon season like we have in India right now. And if you're a person who likes psychological thrillers or just thrillers in general, then you have to try this one. Next one in the list is The Hunger Games by Suzanne Collins. I'm sure everyone knows what The Hunger Games is. It's actually this trilogy about a girl named Katniss Everdeen who has to participate in this reality show called The Hunger Games, in which two people from every district are selected. There are totally 13 districts and there are 26 participants on the 12 districts and 24 participants on the whole. And during this year of The Hunger Games, Katniss is selected, and she actually doesn't get selected. She volunteers instead of her sister, and she tries to protect her sister and her family. Will Katniss win The Hunger Games or not? The actual plot or the catch in The Hunger Games is that 24 people participate, but only one survives at the end, and that one will be the title winner. And it's really sick and very, very interesting in every sense. Just read the first and second books and don't read the third one. Just make your mind that the second one is the climax, and don't read the third book and spoil your mood, because I've done it. The last one in this list is actually a very obvious one, and it is Harry Potter by J.K. Rowling. This consists of 7 books as a series, and it's about this 11-year-old boy who discovers that he's a wizard, that is a person who can do magic, and there's this parallel world in which wizards and witches actually live, and magic is being taught to children from their young age. And so Harry is trained. The relevance of the title, book's title is actually, it's based upon the main character's name, Harry Potter. I'm sure everyone knows. Okay, I just want to include this in the list because if any book deserves to be in this list, it's Harry Potter for sure, and that's why I'm including it. That's all for today, and if you did enjoy watching this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and also share it to your friends. If you want to get more content from me, do subscribe to the channel, because I publish new videos every Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday. Thanks for watching, and have a great rest of your day.